Chapter 34. The Lord said to Moses, "Cut two stone tablets like the first, and I will write on the tablets the words which were on the first tablets, which you broke in pieces. Be ready by morning. Then in the morning go up Mount Sinai. Stand and wait for me there on the top. No man shall go up with you. No man shall even be seen anywhere on the mountain, nor shall flock or herds graze within sight of that mountain." So Moses cut two stone tablets like the first, and he rose early in the morning and went up Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking the two stone tablets in his hands. And the Lord came down to the cloud and took his place beside him and pronounced the name Jehovah. Then the Lord passed in front of him and called aloud, "Jehovah the Lord, a God compassionate and gracious, long-suffering, ever constant and true, maintaining constancy to thousands, forgiving iniquity, rebellion, and sin, and not sweeping the guilty clean away, but one who punishes sons and grandsons to the third and fourth generation, for the iniquity of their fathers." Moses made haste, bowed to the ground, and prostrated himself. He said, "If I have indeed won thy favour, O Lord, then may the Lord go in our company. However stubborn a people they are, forgive our iniquity and our sin, and take us as thy own possession." The Lord said, "Here and now I make a covenant. In full view of all your people, I will do such miracles as has never been performed in all the world or in any nation. All the surrounding people shall see the work of the Lord, for fearful is that which I will do for you. Observe all I command you this day, and I for my part will drive out before you the Amorites, and the Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Perizzites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Be careful not to make a covenant with the natives of the land against which you are going, or they will prove a snare in your midst. No, you shall demolish their altars, smash their sacred pillars, and cut down their sacred poles. You shall not prostrate yourself to any other god, for the Lord's name is a jealous God, and a jealous God he is. Be careful not to make a covenant with the natives of the land, or when they go wantonly after their gods and sacrifice to them, you may be invited, any one of you, to partake of their sacrifices, and marry your sons to their daughters, and when their daughters go wantonly after their gods, they may lead your sons astray too. You shall not make yourself gods of cast metal. You shall observe the pilgrim feast of unleavened bread. For 7 days, as I have commanded you, you shall eat unleavened cakes at the appointed time in the month of Abib, because in the month of Abib you went out from Egypt. Every first birth of the womb belongs to me, and the males of all your herds, both cattle and sheep. You may buy back the first birth of an ass by giving a sheep instead, but if you do not buy it, you must break its neck. You shall buy back all the firstborn of your sons, and no one shall come into my presence empty-handed. For 6 days you shall work, but on the 7th day you shall cease work. Even at ploughing time and harvest you shall cease work. You shall observe the pilgrim feast of weeks, the first fruits of the wheat harvest, and the pilgrim feast of ingathering at the turn of the year. 3 times a year all your males shall come into the presence of the Lord the God of Israel. For after I have driven out the nations before you, and extended your frontiers, there will be no danger from covetous neighbours when you go up these 3 times to enter the presence of the Lord your God. You shall not offer the blood of my sacrifice at the same time as anything leavened, nor shall any portion of the victim of the pilgrim feast of Passover remain overnight till morning. You shall bring the choicest firstfruits of your soil to the house of the Lord your God. You shall not boil a kid in its mother's milk. The Lord said to Moses, write these words down, because the covenant I make with you and with Israel is in these words. So Moses stayed there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights, neither eating nor drinking, and wrote down the words of the covenant, the 10 words, on the tablets. At length Moses came down from Mount Sinai with the 2 stone tablets of the tokens in his hands. And when he descended, he did not know that the skin of his face shone, because he had been speaking with the Lord. When Aaron and the Israelites saw how the skin of Moses' face shone, they were afraid to approach him. He called out to them, and Aaron and all the chiefs in the congregation turned towards him. Moses spoke to them, and afterwards all the Israelites drew near. He gave them all the commands with which the Lord had charged them on Mount Sinai, and finished what he had to say. Then Moses put a veil over his face, and whenever he went in before the Lord to speak with him, he removed the veil until he came out. Then he would go out and tell the Israelites all the commands he had received. Whenever the skin of Moses' face shone in the sight of the Israelites, he would put the veil back over his face until he went in again to speak with the Lord.